Hello friends, in this video we shall discuss a very important part of a modern day computer programming architecture, which is called as garbage collection. What is a garbage and what is a garbage collection? First let us try to understand what these two terms are. Whenever a computer program is executed, the computer program uses a certain memory of the processor. The operating system allocates the required memory to the program. During the course of the program, certain memory locations are used up in the form of variables. Okay, so those memory locations are used by the computer program. As the program is over, does those memory location, do those memory locations used by that program are reclaimed by the operating system? That is the point. If those memory locations are not reclaimed or returned back to the operating system, for the operating system, as far as the operating system is concerned, those memory locations are garbage because they are not useful for any other purpose. That is called as a garbage. So now we will see what is the garbage collection. In some of the earlier or older programming languages, there was no facility of clearing this garbage automatically. So the onus was on really the programmer to see to it that as the program is over, as the program comes to the end of execution, the programmer should manually clear the garbage. In other words, return the memory used by the program back to the operating system. Otherwise, what will happen? For example, if in a program a certain, let us say 100 bytes are used by a certain program to store some data, and then the program exits, but for the operating system those 100 bytes are still allocated. Okay, so those 100 bytes are garbage as far as the operating system is concerned. Now if you execute the second program, it will again take up 100 bytes, and after the execution of that program also, the additional 100 bytes will be also become garbage. So if that goes on, then what will happen? A time will come when, in spite of the fact that no activity, no program is running, the operating system will still say that it doesn't have any memory. That is because the heap of garbage is being collected. More and more garbage is being created. So such a problem has to be eliminated in two ways: either manually clearing the garbage, manually reclaiming or returning the used memory back to the operating system. That used to be the case in C or C++. But the modern programming languages like Python, Java, or some other examples, in which the language runtime, in this case the Python interpreter is the runtime environment. This runtime environment has a continuously running garbage collector program. And what is the role of that garbage collector? It will be always on the lookout for what are the different memory locations which are no more in use. So those memory locations which have no use, no further use, that memory location doesn't have any reference to the executing program. So such memory locations are automatically cleared, reclaimed. That is called as garbage collection. Now coming back to the Python's environment, Python's garbage collector deletes unnecessary objects automatically. So you as a programmer does not have to worry about what to do about the garbage. And by reclaiming that memory, the memory space is freed. This process is called as a garbage collection. Python's garbage collector runs during the program execution. When the interpreter starts, executing a program, it also starts a garbage collector. Okay, and if during the course of the program, if a particular object has a reference in the program, as many times the reference is created, the reference count is incremented. And as soon as or as and when that particular reference is being dereferenced, it is decremented. So what will happen? A time, if at all, it comes so that there is no more reference to that particular object. The count, if it reaches to zero, at that moment, what will happen? The garbage collector will reclaim. The object's reference count increases when it is assigned a new name, and decreases or decrements when it is deleted or with the delete. So there is a initialization activity, or reference will be incremented. Delete activity, it will be decremented. As it reaches zero, the garbage collector will reclaim. So that is how Python's runtime will ensure that there is a garbage free environment in your program. So it is a very important feature of any modern day programming language, and specifically Python. So that was about the garbage collection feature.